In this video, we're introducing the idea of cyclotron motion. So this is the uniform circular motion of a charged particle in a magnetic field. So in the diagram, I have a particle with a positive charge on it, and it's moving with a speed of v perfectly to the right when it enters this magnetic field that's pointing inward. That's what the x's mean for the direction. And I just want to work things out qualitatively real quick. So let's look at the particle after it's gone into the magnetic field. So at this moment, I still have a rightward velocity, and I have this inward magnetic field. And we can find the direction of the magnetic force on this particle by pointing our fingers in the direction of V, and then sweeping out to the direction of B, and your thumb will point in the direction of the magnetic force. So that looks something like this. And I see that my thumb is pointing up. So the magnetic force is upward here. I'll call that FB. And it's important to note that the magnetic force is always perpendicular to the velocity. Well, that means that force can't be speeding up the particle or slowing it down. A force perpendicular to the motion does no work. So my speed's always going to stay the same. And all this force can do is turn the velocity vector. So it's going to rotate it a little bit counterclockwise now. I can visualize my particle a moment later. Again, the speed is going to be exactly the same because forces that are perpendicular to the direction of motion can't do any work. I run through the right-hand rule again, and I put my fingers in the direction of V, sweep out to the direction of B, and now my thumb is still pointing at the center of curvature for this path. Again, that's exactly perpendicular to the velocity. And now I'm starting to get the idea. The force always points to the center of curvature for the path of this object. And what I'm looking at is an example of uniform circular motion. So now I can get into the physics analysis, and just a quick reminder to begin with, the magnitude of the magnetic force is given by the Lorentz force law, and I'll post a link real quick to where this was first introduced. And the sine of theta there, the theta is the angle between the velocity vector and the magnetic field, and that's 90 degrees in this case, because my magnetic field is perfectly into the page, and my velocity is within the plane of the page. Well, with theta equals 90 degrees, my magnetic force is maxed out. Sine theta is 1, and I get a magnetic force magnitude of QVB. Now I simply apply Newton's second law to this particle. F net equals MA. And there's only one force acting on it, it's the magnetic force. And the acceleration, now that I know that I'm looking at uniform circular motion, the acceleration is V squared over R, where R is the radius of curvature. I plug in my magnetic force, cancel one factor of V, and I'm going to say my motivation here is to solve for the radius of curvature. So I get MV over QB. Next, we're going to apply our new formula to a simple example. In the example, I have a proton, and I'm giving you the proton mass here as 1.0073 atomic mass units. An atomic mass unit converts to kilograms like this. And I have a speed of 2.2 times 10 to the fifth meters per second. If you're curious how we can control the speed of a proton entering a magnetic field, you do it by using a velocity selector device. And I'll post a link real quick to the video where we work this out. And then I'm told that my magnetic field has a strength of 2.0 teslas. Our goal is to get the radius of curvature for this proton. So just as a side note, let's get the mass of the proton in kilograms. 1.0073 atomic mass units multiplied by 1.66 times 10 to the negative 27 kilograms for each atomic mass unit. And my atomic mass units cancel out. And I've got 1.67, just keeping three sig figs, times 10 to the negative 27 kilograms. It looks like everything else is ready to go into our radius of curvature formula. So I have MV over QB. And I need to remember the elementary charge on a proton real quick. That's 1.60 times 10 to the negative 19 coulombs. And then finally, my magnetic field was 2.0 tesla. And I get 0.0011, just keeping two sig figs here, meters. And I could write that as 1.1 millimeters, radius of curvature. If you find the physics content on Zach's Lab helpful, click on the Zach's Lab logo on the right to browse playlists and subscribe to the channel. I produce over 100 new videos per month, and subscribing is the easiest way to find new content. Thanks for watching.